فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
دار القطني is giving you متابعات. He knows حماد بن سلمة narrated from عطاء بن سائب in his what قبل الاختلاط بعض الاختلاط اختلاط we don't know when it is but he already overcame that question because he brought a sanad from حماد بن سلمة ابن دينار narrated from who يونس بن عبيد. And Yunus ibn Ubayd is narrating from who? Ayyub al-Sakhtiyani and then Habib ibn Abi Shahid and then Muhammad Sayyid and Abi Huraira. So he's bringing you another riwayah, which is the same, which is Hamad ibn Salama, narrated from Ata ibn Sa'ibin. But then here, what does it say? An Abdillahi, sah? Does it say an Abdillahi? Ibn Abdillahi ibn Utbah. Yeah. That's another tasheef. On the nuskha of Sheikh Abdullah ibn Muhammad al-Ghunayman. It's another mistake there. You need to correct, which is an Ubaydullah has been tasghir. It is not an Abdullahi. It is an Ubaydullah ibn Abdullahi ibn Utbah. Sahih? It's a tasheef. An Abi Sa'id al-Khudri. An Abi Sa'id. Because it's weird because Sheikh Abdullah ibn Hamd al-Ghunayman didn't see it because the previous hadith it says it. Look, if you look at Ubaydullah ibn Abdullahi ibn Ubaydullah, yeah? Ibn Abdullah ibn Utbah, right? Yes. Ali ibn Sa'id al-Khudri. Yes. This is the same sanad. Are you with me?
Yes.
So the Sheikh got it wrong. It's a hif from his, from him. Which is, it's a half-word mistake from the Sheikh. An Abdullah ibn Ubaydullah, an Ubaydullah ibn Abdullah ibn Utbah, an Abi Sa'id al-Khudri, an Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, iftakharat al-Jannah wa naq, thumma dhakara nahwahu. So it's the same narration. It's the same narration, nothing more, nothing less. حدثنا الإمام الدارقطني says حدثنا محمد بن مخلد وأيوب طالب الحافظ. So here, how many people did he narrate from? How many people has he narrated from? Yeah. الإمام الدارقطني. How many people has he narrated from here? No, this one, this particular hadith one. He narrated from two people at the same time. He's saying, I've narrated from Muhammad ibn Makhlad and I also narrated from Talib al-Hafidh, both of them. Are you with me, brothers? Ahmed ibn Nasr. So, Abu Talib al-Hafidh, his name is what? His name is Ahmed ibn Nasr. His name is Ahmed ibn Nasr. Al-Imam al-Dhahabi in Sir Alam al-Nubala, the 15th volume, page 68, he brings him. He says, Al-Hafidh, al-Mutqin, al-Imam, muhaddith Baghdad. Abu Talib Ahmed ibn Nasr ibn Talib al-Baghdadi. Reliable person. Very reliable. Rahimahullah ta'ala. Qala, he says, حدثنا محمد ibn غالب ibn حرب. محمد ibn غالب ibn حرب. Khatib al-Baghdadi has his biography in his Tariq al-Baghdad. And his kunya is Abu Ja'far al-Dibbi al-Tammar al-Ma'rufu bit-Tamtam. He was very well known as the name is Tamtam. كان كثير حديث صدوق. He was a one who narrated hadith a lot, and he was صدوقاً حافظاً. He was reliable and he was a man of حفظ. وثقه الدارقطني. الإمام الدارقطني said he is reliable. One of the like in Oham that he fell into. And one of the mistakes that he fell into, wahm from him, that is the narration of شَيَّبَتْنِي هُودٌ وَأَخْوَاتُهَا. You know that narration where the Prophet is beard? Yeah? Being white. Ha. These are from the awham that are proud from him. It's a wahm minhu. Okay? And then he goes on to saying, حَدَّثَنَا عَبْدُ الرَّحْمَنِ بْنُ السَّلَامِ الْقُرَشِيِّ. عَبْدُ الرَّحْمَنِ بْنُ سَلَامِ الْقُرَشِيِّ. عَبْدُ الرَّحْمَنِ بْنُ سَلَامِ الْقُرَشِيِّ. عبد الرحمن بن سلام ابن عبد his name is called عبد الرحمن بن سلام ابن عبيد الله ابن سالم القرشي الجمحي. الإمام أبو حاتم الرازي was asked about him and he said صدوق reliable person in جرح التعديل 5th volume page 242. He was asked about him. So is this narration is what حماد بن سلمة عن يونس بن عبيد عن محمد بن سيرين عن أبي هريرة وتقول هل من مزيد, which is like the previous narration we took that. حدثنا الإمام الدارقطني سيد حدثنا أحمد بن محمد بن سعيد أحمد بن محمد بن سعيد أخبرنا الحسن بن سعيد بن عثمان حدثنا أبي حدثنا حسين بن مخارق عن يونس بن عبيد وداود بن أبي هند وصالح المري عن محمد بن سيرين عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تزال جهنم يلقى فيها وتقول هل من مزيد. Look at this now. This narration is narrated from Ahmed ibn Muhammad ibn Sa'id. Ahmed ibn Muhammad ibn Sa'id. His tarjama you can find in Sir Alam al-Nubala, 15th volume, page 340. You see, his name is Ahmed ibn Muhammad ibn Sa'id, Abu al-Abbas al-Kufi al-Hafidh al-Allama. أحد أعلام الحديث ونادر الزمان وصاحب التصانيف. He was a man who was very well known for his knowledge of hadith, a reliable individual, as Imam al-Dhahabi said about him in his kitab Sir Alam al-Nubala. He then narrates from أخبرنا الحسن بن سعيد بن عثمان. This Hassan, this individual, sorry, Ahmed ibn Muhammad ibn Sa'id, Ahmed ibn Muhammad ibn Sa'id, he said, he narrated from who? Al-Hassan ibn Sa'id. Al-Hassan ibn Sa'id. Naam, Al-Hassan ibn Sa'id, right? Ibn Uthman. This biography, I tried to look for it in Sir Alam al-Nubala, Tariqu Baghdad, or other books of hadith. Couldn't find him. I struggled. Very good. So I couldn't find him. And then he goes, حدثنا أبي, my father told me. And I couldn't even find the tarjama of his father as well. So both of them, I لم أجده. I could not find it in كتب التراجم. I couldn't find it in the books of biography of the scholars of hadith. إذا حدثنا حسين بن مخارق. حدثنا حسين بن مخارق. حسين بن مخارق بن ورقاء أبو جنادة. دارقطني said يضع الحديث. He places حديث. ابن حبان said لا يجوز الاحتجاج به. It is not permissible to use زمان evidence. حسين بن مخارق narrated from يونس بن عبيد. And we spoke about يونس بن عبيد in the sixth hadith. يونس بن عبيد narrated from who? داود بن أبي هند. He's a ثقة متقن. But then he started to fall in some أوهام in the narrations in his later stages in his life. But he's from the scholars of the books of the six books of hadith. He narrated from who? He narrated from صالح المري. His name is صالح بن بشير بن وادع. And he's weak in narration. He's weak. Muhammad ibn, he narrated from Muhammad ibn Sirin ala Abi Hurairata that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, لا تزال جهنم يلقى فيها جهنم. Are you there? It will not remain if the people being thrown in it except وتقولوا. Shaykh Abdullah's Nusqa says what? Shaykh Abdullah ibn Ghulayman's Nusqa says ونقولوا. That's wrong. How is it ونقولوا? We're not saying this. وتقولوا, we're talking about جهنم. وتقول جهنم وسي هل من مزيد. Is there any زيادة left? حتى يضع الجبار. تبارك وتعالى. This hadith is very powerful. This hadith is very powerful. This حتى يضع, if you look at the أصل of the نسخة, the manuscript, the original copy, the word يضع is, it was dropped from it. Wherever the ناسخ must have got it wrong. So remember to say يضع. الجبار here is a فاعل, right? الجبار here is what? استفاعل. All the other previous times, what we were hearing? حتى يضع قدمه. We had pronoun, right? We had ضمير, right? And now we don't have the ضمير. We actually what? We have the فاعل, main, تعيين الفاعل, specified Allah. So it's a stronger meaning than حتى يضع قدمه, until he places his foot in it. But here we have حتى يضع الجبار تبارك وتعالى. الله تبارك. فيها قدمه, he places his foot in it. So we got that. That's good. This is the extra meaning it gives you. فهنالك تنزوي. And at this particular point, the hellfire comes together. وتقول قط قط. It says enough, enough, enough. What does it say? It says enough, enough, enough. حدثنا جعفر بن محمد بن يعقوب الصندلي. حدثنا الحسن بن محمد الزعفراني. This narration is جعفر ابن محمد ابن يعقوب الصندلي خطيب البغدادي يسأل وكان ثقة صالحا دينا. He was a reliable person of religion. He narrated from who? الحسن بن محمد ابن الصباح الزعفراني أبو علي البغدادي who resided in Baghdad ثقة من رجال كتب الستة. He's from the books كتب الستة, you find him in there. Pay attention to this individual الحسن بن محمد الصباح الزعفراني. He is a student of Imam Shafi'i رحمه الله. He took knowledge from him. And he was with the Imam Ahmed studying with Imam Shafi'i in Baghdad. When Shafi'i was in Baghdad, he was there, Al-Hasan ibn Muhammad ibn Sabbah al-Za'farani, and he was the scholar who would read on Imam Shafi'i, and Shafi'i would then explain. Scholars have somebody who reads on them, right? Yeah? He was the reader who read on who? Al-Imam Shafi'i. And this mentioning, this is very powerful, especially for Imam Shafi'i, rahimahullah, because Imam Shafi'i was a hujjah in Arabic language, hujjah, proof. The way he spoke was a proof for you. If you look at the Muqaddimah, the introduction of Jumma'u al-Ilm, وكتاب الرسالة as well, when Ahmed Shakir talks about Imam al-Shafi'i and his knowledge of the language, he mentions it there. It was a proof in the Arabic language of Imam al-Shafi'i. So for him to be allowed to read to Imam al-Shafi'i and to be the reader for Shafi'i shows you his understanding of the language as well, صح? Al-Hasan ibn Muhammad al-Sabbah al-Za'farani. So he was a scholar, very strong, thiqatun. And he was of the level of, he was studying with him when Ahmed ibn Hanbal was studying with him, when Abu Thawr was studying with him, when Al-Husayn ibn Ali al-Karabisi, all of them were studying together with Imam Shafi'i in Baghdad at that time. You see? So this is who he is. He then says, حدثنا شبابته. You narrated from who? شبابه. حدثنا ورقاء عن أبي زناد عن الأعرج عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال. He narrated from who? شبابة, whose name is ابن سوار الفزاري أبو عمرو المدائني, who is a ثقة حافظ. ورقاء is ابن عمر ابن كليب اليشكري صدوق, he's reliable, but in his hadith from منصور he's weak, he's لين الحديث when it comes to his narrations from منصور. أبو زناد, his name is محمد ابن عبد الله ابن ذكوان القرشي أبو عبد الله عبد الرحمن المدني ثقة فقيه من فقهاء المدينة, he's from the jurists of Medina who's very well known for his knowledge. الأعرج, he's عبد الرحمن ابن هرمز الأعرج أبو داود المدني ثقة reliable strong in his narrations. نعم, so he narrated from Abu Hurairah رضي الله تعالى عنه, from the Prophet Abu Hurairah, that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, تحاجت الجنة والنار, the Jannah and the Nar argued. فقالت النار, the Nar said, أوثرت بالمتكبرين, I was the arrogant ones, I have been placed inside them. Those were the ones who I was chosen for. والمتجبرين and the tyrant ones. وقالت الجنة, فما لي لا يدخلني إلا ضعفاء الناس وسقاطهم. And then the Jannah says, why is it that no one enters me except the weak ones and the low-classed ones? فقال الله عز وجل للجنة, Allah said to the Jannah, أنت رحمتي و my mercy. أنت رحمتي. You see, أرحم بك من أشاء من عبادي. I reward you with whoever I wish for my creations. So we have the characteristics of الرحمة here for Allah تبارك وتعالى. Because Allah is saying, أنت رحمتي أرحم. Are you with me? So Allah تبارك وتعالى has these characteristics. So this is a characteristic of Allah تبارك وتعالى. And this, the word أوثرتو shows that it is تخصيص specifically for the Jannah. That the poor ones are going to enter. That's عجيب. صحيح? And the people are looked down at. But they are ضعفاء and they're سقطهم. This is, but not in their religion. In their worldly, they're weak. They have nothing. They're مساكين. فقراء إلى الله تبارك وتعالى. أنت رحمتي, you are my mercy. أرحم بك من أشاء من عبادي. Allah is affirming for himself the characteristics of mercy. وقال للنار, Allah then says to the hellfire, أنت عذابي, you are my punishment. وعذب بك من أشاء من عبادي, I punish you with whoever I wish for my creations. وَلِكُلِّ وَاحِدٍ مِنْكُمَا مِلْءُهَا. And both of you, I will fill you. You will both have your fill. فَأَمَّا النَّارُ فَلَا تَمْتَلِئُ حَتَّى فَأَمَّا النَّارُ فَلَا تَمْتَلِئُ فَيَضَعُ قَدَمَهُ عَلَيْهَا. The nar doesn't get full. So this shows us it doesn't get full from all of its corners. That's what it means. And then Allah places His foot inside it. فَتَقُولُ قَدْ قَدْ. Then the hellfire goes, enough, enough, enough. فَهُنَالِكَ تَمْتَلِئُ وَيُزْوَى بَعْضُهَا إِلَى بَعْضٍ. And it all comes together, the hellfire. أخرجه مسلم بن الحجاج النيسابوري. Imam Muslim, غني عن التعريف. I won't even try to explain who Imam Muslim is. Yeah? Muslim بن الحجاج. Muslim, his name is Hussein بن حجاج النيسابوري رحمه الله تعالى. غني عن التعريف. غني. This riwaya, Warqa, are you with me? He has a mutaba'a in his narration here right now from by who? Imam Muslim brings it. From who? An Muhammad ibn Rafi'. Some of the nusaqs by accidentally is tasheef in there. Instead of saying Muhammad ibn Rafi', what does it say? It says Muhammad ibn Nafi'. That's tasheef, that's not right. It's Muhammad ibn Rafi'. Go to the nusaqs Sahih Muslim, see for yourself. It's Muhammad ibn Rafi'. So, who Warqa has a mutaba'a here? Are you with me? Yeah. So he's a mutaba'a. He has somebody who supports him. Very good. His mutaba'at are Warqa ibn Uyayna, Abdullah ibn Abdul Rahman ibn Abi Zinad. Yeah? Abu Abdul Rahman. Abdul Rahman ibn Abi Zinad. And Shu'aib ibn Abi Hamza. So all of those are mutaba'at for Warqa ibn Amr. His name is Ibn Umar ibn Kulayb al-Yashkuri. They're all a mutaba'a for him. Also, what you need to remember is لم يتفرد به أبو زيناد عن الأعرج. Don't think that the only Abu Zinad was not the only person who narrated from al-A'raj. Abdul Rahman ibn Hurmuz al-A'raj, Abu Dawood al-Madani. He has a mutaba'a as well. Salih ibn Kaysan narrated it with him. Salih ibn Kaysan narrated it with him. So that's in terms of that narration. Then Al-Imam al-Darqutni says, and then Imam al-Darqutni says, حدثنا محمد بن عبد الله الشافعي حدثنا إسحاق بن الحسن حدثنا أبو سلمة موسى بن إسماعيل حدثنا حماد بن سلمة عن عمار بن أبي عمار عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه قال. This narration here right now, محمد بن عبد الله الشافعي. His name is محمد بن عبد الله بن إبراهيم بن عبدويه الإمام المحدث المتقن الحجة الفقيه مسند العراق أبو بكر البغدادي الشافعي. He narrated from who? إسحاق بن الحسن. His name is إسحاق بن الحسن الحربي ثقة حجة وثقه دارقطني وغيره. إسحاق بن الحسن الحربي is a reliable proof, strong. الإمام دارقطني authenticated it. You can find it in الميزان والاعتدال and also لسان الميزان. أبو سلمة موسى بن إسماعيل العنقري. We took him, Abu Salamat al-Tabudaki, right? Al-Minqari, sorry. Abu Salamat al-Tabudaki, we mentioned him before. حدثنا حماد بن سلمة, we know حماد بن سلمة. You see, عن عمار. What does the Nuskha Sheikh Abdullah ibn Muhammad al-Ghunayman say?
العمار ابن عمار.
Ah, جميل. Some copies, what did they do? They actually, instead of saying that, they said Hamad ibn Salamah Abi Ammar. So they made it like his own name. That his name is Hamad ibn Salamah Abi Ammar. This is a mistake. So it's rather it is An Ammar ibn Abi Ammar. So Sheikh Abdullah ibn Ghunayman tafattana li dhalik. He pointed that out, mashallah. He saw that. نعم. So he pointed it out. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه So who is this Ammar ibn Abi Ammar? It is said Abu Amr. ويقال, some say Abu Abdullah al-Makki. You see? عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول I heard the prophet saying يلقى في النار a people will be thrown into the hellfire وتقول then the hellfire will say هل من مزيد is there any act additional مرتين it will say it twice حتى يأتيها تبارك وتعالى until Allah comes فيضع قدمه فيها and he places his foot in there وتنزوي وتقول قط قط and then the hellfire comes together and it says enough, enough. It says what? Enough, enough. Then Imam Ad-Darqutni rahimahullah, he brings hadathana. And this is the last hadith of that chapter. He says, hadathana Muhammad ibn Abdullah, hadathana Ishaq ibn al-Hasan, hadathana Abu Salamah, hadathana Hamad, an Ata'i ibn al-Sa'ibi, an Ubaidullah ibn Abdullah ibn Utbah, an Abi Sa'id al-Khudri. The original copy, the asal, the nuskha, the original manuscript, the word Abi Sa'id al-Khudri was missing from it. Abi is missing from it. So we know who Muhammad ibn Abdullah is. We know Ishaq ibn Hassan, who he is. Abu Salama, we know his tarjama. Hamad ibn Salama, we know him. Ata ibn Sa'ib, we know who he is. Ubaidullah ibn Abdullah ibn Utbah, we know who he is. We all mention all of them. Who narrated from Abi Sa'id al-Khudri, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, anna Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, iftakharati al-jannah. The word iftakharati fell off the original copy. It was also missing from the original manuscript. So iftakharati al-jannah wal-nar. The jannah and the nar boasted to one another. Faqalati al-nar, the nar said, Ya Rabbi, my Lord, yadukhuluni, the nar said, it will enter me al-jabbaruna. Yeah? So the Imam Ibn Khuzaymah's Tawheed, Kitab al-Tawheed, it mentions that there's a waw and noon after al-jabbaruna. This manuscript didn't have that. It just says, yadkhuluni al-jabbaru wal-muluku wal-ashrafu. So it's al-jabbaruna, the tyrant ones. Wal-muluku, the leaders. Wal-ashrafu, the tribal leaders. Waqalat al-jannah, the jannah then said, Ya Rabbi, my Lord. So also waqalat was missing from it, from the original copy. It's also missing from the original copy. Ibn Khuzaymah brings it in his Kitab al-Tawheed. Ibn Khuzaymah brings that also in his Kitab al-Tawheed. Very good. نعم. افتقر الجنة والنار فقالت النار يا ربي يدخلني الجبارون والملوك والأشراف وقالت الجنة the جنة says يا ربي يدخلني الفقراء والضعفاء والمساكين the فقراء will enter me the weak ones would enter me and the مساكين the poor ones and the needy فقال الله الله then says للنار to the hellfire أنت عذابي you are my punishment أصيب بك من أشاء I will afflict you with whoever I want from my creation وقالت وقال للجنة الله then says to the جنة أنت رحمتي you are my mercy وسعت كل شيء vast over everything ولكل واحدة منكما ملؤها both of you have your filling فأما النار فيلقى فيها that فيها is also missing from the original copy the فيها is missing from it فأما النار فيلقى فيها and then the people will be thrown into the hellfire. You see, فَتَقُولُ then the hellfire will then say, هَلْ مِن مَزِيدٍ is there any more additional. ثلاثة مرات, it says it three times. حَتَّى يَأْتِيَا تَبَارَكُ وَتَعَالَى until Allah تَبَارَكُ وَتَعَالَى comes to it. فَيَضَعُ قَدَمَهُ عَلَيْهَا and he places his foot in it. فَيَزْوِي بَعْ وَتَقُولُ قِدْنِي قِدْنِي فَيَنْزَوِي وَتَقُولُ قِدْنِي قِدْنِي The hellfire comes together and then it says enough. So here what we learn from these ahadith is إثبات الرجل والقدم لله تبارك وتعالى. And these are صفات ذاتية. That these are characteristics of Allah تبارك وتعالى. And they are like صفة الوجه واليدين. You see? And according to the عقيدة أهل السنة والجماعة is what? That it's obligatory to affirm that which Allah تبارك وتعالى affirmed for himself. Or that which his messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم affirmed for him. And we have to affirm it in the apparent meaning that these verses and these ahadith show. And that is what Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah. But rather, we affirm it. What we also affirm is that Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala's Qadam is not one, that it's two. And we mentioned, remember the statement of the great noble companion Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, that he says Al Kursiyu mawdu'u al qadamaini wal arsh. So he said the kursi is Allah's footstool. But he says qadamaini, two footstools. He's the two foots of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Hakim narrated it in his Mustadrak. He authenticated it and he said it's ala shart al-shaykhaini, it's of the conditions of Bukhari and Muslim. And al-Imam al-Dhahabi agreed with him on that. So this shows that Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah, when they had said amirruha kama ja'at bila kayfin, this hadith enters it. We have to affirm it as it is. And we cannot give it interpretations and ta'wilat. Goes against tariqatu salafi salih ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'in. Now, that chapter is over. The author, rahimahullah ta'ala, he goes on to the next chapter, which is ithbatu liyadayni lillahi azza wa jalla. Affirming two hands for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And that is what is going to be the next chapter. We are not going to do it now. We're going to stop there, inshallah ta'ala. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.